Good afternoon, and welcome to the Buffalo Review TV. I'm Jess Frieda.
And I'm Nazeh Wright. Today's show, we will discuss a new policy act, the opening of Hotel Henry, and so much more.
Now, from the campus of SUNY Buffalo State, news and information for Buffalo and the surrounding communities, it's the Buffalo Review TV, produced by Stripes Media.
University police at Buffalo State are investigating an assault that occurred in the R14 parking lot on the west side of campus early Sunday morning on April 16th. At approximately 2:58 a.m., a male student reported that he was attacked from behind and stabbed in the back with an unknown object by an unknown individual. The incident is believed to be connected to a fight that occurred at an off-campus party near the intersection of Reese and Forest overnight as students returned to campus. The victim was treated and released from ECMC since. A description of the suspect is not currently available. The matter is under investigation by Buffalo State University Police and Buffalo Police. If you have any information about this crime, we encourage you to call University Police at 716-838-6333. There's been a new policy at Buffalo State College, which has implemented a new visitation policy for the residence halls on campus. Resident students are not permitted to have guests in their hall or bedroom. The rule will be enforced starting Monday, May 8th at 8 a.m. Monday, May 8th is also the start of CEP week for Buffalo State students. The rule will come to an end on Thursday, May 11th at the end of CEP week. The escort and visitation was started last academic year and will continue on. On May 12th, residence halls will be closed to undergraduate students until fall, with the exception of graduating seniors.
With the semester winding down, the students in the Fine Arts Department will be exhibiting their work Upton Hall's Cyril's Nelson Gallery. Fine arts majors have been working extremely hard on producing their pieces to showcase. Some of the students' artwork ranges from painting to sculptures that shows how interactive works. For example, one student last year had an instrument displayed for all people to play. Upton Hall is located in the back of Buffalo State College by Residence Hall Cassidy. The gallery is open from 9:30 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. Admission is free to the public. The Buffalo State Vocal Jazz Ensemble will perform a concert with a number of local high school choirs. The performance will take place on Saturday, April 29th at 7:30 p.m. in the Performing Arts Center at Rockwell Hall. The concert is expected to be lively as students will get together to create an entertaining show. The event is open to all students. Tickets are free with your school ID and $10 for the general public. To purchase tickets, you can visit the Rockwell box office from 9:30 a.m. to 5 p.m.
Next up, we have Greg Garrett, who will be discussing the upcoming grand opening of Hotel Henry.
For over 50 years, the Otis Island sat vacant on Buffalo State's college campus. In just a few short days, it will be transformed into Hotel Henry. The multi-million dollar resort and conference room will be open April 30th.
For the first time ever, Hotel Henry will be open to the general public. The establishment, designed by Flynn Battaglia Architects, suffered several delays in the design process. The project, which began the fall of 2012, took over 4 years to complete. Architect Courtney Creenan Corley is relieved the process is coming to a close.
I'm excited and relieved that we're actually able to open and have the general public actually use the building, because the space, it's never been accessible to the general public before, so this is really the first time that it'll be open and available to really anyone that wants to go inside. About 4.5 years, we started in the fall of 2012. We started the design process, and it's been under construction for almost 3 years. Mm-hmm. It's a hotel. There's a conference and event center, and then there are a few galleries for an architecture center as well, so there'll be some kind of history component to it. Well, the part that we worked on is about 180,000 square feet. So there's 88 hotel rooms, and then there's a handful of conference rooms and like small meeting spaces. But then there's also a large ballroom that that weddings could rent out, or for conferences for like larger kind of keynote sessions. So it's quite a large space with a lot of different moving parts going on at the same time.
For more information, visit the website at www.hotelhenry.com or call 716-882-1970. For more information, visit the website at www.hotelhenry.com or call 716-882-1970.
Buffalo's top of the charts, highly anticipated weekly event is back, Food Truck Tuesdays. The event is located in Larkin Square on every Tuesday until October 3rd from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m., with the exception of July 4th, with free admission and parking. It's sponsored by KeyBank and Independent Health. The event has over 50 food trucks and 25 vans to entertain the city of Buffalo. There will be new trucks added onto the list this year. Some includes Cheesecake Guy, Jimmy Z's, Healthy Scratch, and much more. Also, new music acts will be making an appearance at the event as well. For example, Nikki Hicks and Mama's Biscuits, Sharon Bailey Project, and Tommy Z Van will be making appearances.
The March of Dimes is hosting an event to support March for Babies. This walk and 5K will be held on Sunday, April 30th at Canalside. The event will focus on improving health of babies in order to raise money and awareness. The walk is free and open to all and will include a 1.88-mile march throughout downtown Buffalo. Registration begins at 8 a.m., followed by the start of the march at 11 a.m. For more information, you can visit marchforbabies.org.
Buffalo State College will be holding their fourth annual graduate research fair on May 5th, located in the Houston Gym. The thesis competition will begin from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. Afterwards, the research fair will begin from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. During the thesis competition, graduate students will get a chance to explain their thesis research. There will be cash prizes for the most compelling and entertaining presentation. During the research fair, there will be a poster presentation for graduate students to play. The Graduate Student Association will be sponsoring this event. They will be covering the cost for poster creations for all students who submit their posters to Creative Media Services. Refreshments will be provided, so come out and celebrate research.
The Wisworth Ferguson Planetarium is preparing for a total solar eclipse that will occur this year in mid-August. Reporter Edwin J. Rivera has more on the story.
The Whitworth Ferguson Planetarium is training local educators about the total solar eclipse this year and another set to occur in 2018.
April 20th, teachers and other educators gathered at Buffalo State College's Whitworth Ferguson Planetarium to learn about a total solar eclipse that will occur in mid-August. The eclipse is slated to cover part of the continental United States. Educators learned about certain crafts they could recreate with their students, some specifically using a yardstick, binder clips, rulers, and models of the Earth and Sun to demonstrate the eclipse's distance. Lecturer Tim Collins of the Whitworth Ferguson Planetarium spoke about the specifics of the training as well as a future eclipse set to occur next year.
What we are doing is we are offering a refresher course for educators. That's the teachers, people from the museum, people that are going to be having anything to do with the eclipse and interacting with the public. So we're just giving them some tips on what they're going to be able to talk about, giving them some demonstrations they can do for their audiences, and just have a good time. What they're learning about are the mechanics of the eclipse, as well as the timings and where it's going to occur and when, and also how they occur so they can better tell their people that they're going to be educating how the eclipse works and when it's going to occur. And basically, we're just going to have them relay all this information to others. The eclipse will only last a few minutes, especially since we're only going to get a partial up here in Buffalo. But it's a very rare event, and it is well worth seeing. And for those who are traveling, it's going to be a wonderful experience. But even if you're not traveling, and you do get a chance to see it, even a partial eclipse is an amazing sight.
This week, Buffalo State is holding a number of volunteer events in the Campbell Student Union. Monday, April 24th, student leaders interviewed students about their volunteer work. They also have been promoting community service opportunities throughout the week. Students help make activity kits for children whose parents are currently deployed in the military in partnership with the American Red Cross. The volunteer week will end Friday, April 28th, with students having the opportunity to win prizes during community service trivia event. On Thursday, May 11th, at Pearl Street, Brewery located at 76 Pearl Street, Buffalo, New York, from 5:30 p.m. to 9:30 p.m. SUNY Buffalo State's English Education Program's annual spring banquet will be recognizing the hard work and success of SUNY Buffalo State's English education community, including their students, faculty, and the dedicated classroom teachers we work with. Author and English teacher Nancy Atwell, the winner of the 2015 Global Teacher Prize and Buffalo State's English Education alumna, will deliver the keynote. English teachers from across our region, faculty, cooperating and mentor teachers from local districts, as well as SUNY Buffalo State students and their families will be in attendance. Tickets are $25 and are limited. Please email Dr. James Sarion to reserve your ticket. Coming up next, Khalid Terrell sits down with chemistry professor Bill Durfee to speak about the West Side Rowing Club. We'll be back right after this.
3, 2, 1, cue on take camera 2.
You're watching the Buffalo Review TV, produced by Stripes Media. You can find out more about our show at our website, thebuffalorevue.wordpress.com, and we welcome your feedback. If you have a question, comment, or story idea, you can email us at thebuffalorevue@gmail.com.
Welcome back to Buffalo Review TV. I'm Khalid Terrell. A faculty member is working with the West Side Rowing Club to bring rowing back to Buffalo State. I'm here with Inorganic Chemistry Professor Bill Durfee. Thank you for joining us today, Bill.
My pleasure.
So let's start off. Why don't you tell us how you got involved with rowing?
My interest in rowing dates back to when my kids rowed in high school. They both went to Buffalo City Honors, and my son and daughter rowed for City Honors, and then my daughter stuck with it and rowed to college. And I started rowing actually at our summer place in New Hampshire. Someone actually gave us a single shell. It's a recreational shell. And my daughter has been my coach, and she's a very good coach. And I have found rowing addicting, I'd even say. I get great pleasure out of it.
Yeah. It's real nice. So what inspired you to bring it back to Buffalo State?
Well, I didn't even know for a long time that Buffalo State had a rowing program from the mid-60s until 1974 when it was terminated. But the more I looked into it, I realized that we not only had men's rowing, we were the local rowing, Western New York rowing powerhouse, and even turned out a world champion, Scott Roop, who was the last American man to win the men's lightweight single sculling event.
Okay, so can you tell us a little bit more about the sport, like what's it involved and how it works?
Well, at the college level, which you typically have, most races take place in what's called an eight. That is, they have eight rowers and a coxswain who steers the boat. And the each rower has a single oar. The oars all alternate on sides of the boat, and it's called sweep rowing. That's the main event in collegiate rowing. In fact, for many programs, it's the only event. Occasionally, they will race fours as well.
Now, I understand you had a demonstration the other day featuring the West Side Rowing Club. What role would they have in bringing it back to Buffalo State, if they have one at all?
Well, no, they certainly would have a role. When we rowed back in the 60s and 70s, we rowed out of the West Side Rowing Club. That's where all the boats would be stored. That's where a lot of the training equipment is for the winter training, and also with tanks for teaching rowers how to row. They want to help us get started, to be sure. And there would be, you know, an initial fair amount of equipment that would have to be bought initially, but we could do it through them, getting used equipment and whatnot. So, yeah, they're most anxious to see us rowing again, men and women, I should add.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I understand you're getting it started as a club, but do you plan on turning that into a competitive sport here at Buffalo State?
Well, ultimately, I'd like to do that. This is actually my third attempt to get rowing started at Buffalo State. My first one was back in 2007, and that went absolutely nowhere. I guess there were just certain administrators that didn't want rowing at Buffalo State, and then I proposed it again about a year and a half ago, and that was again turned down. And this is our third attempt. Each of those previous attempts, we tried to get the college to start at least a women's varsity program. The men would probably, if they wanted to row, would have to do it as a club. Since both my earlier proposals were turned down, we thought, well, maybe we would try to form a men's and women's club this time. And that's so at the event that we held on Tuesday, where the weather did not cooperate at all, we still got, I got the email contacts for 20 interested students.
Okay.
And so that's a start.
Well, that has to do with my next question, mm-hmm. Like how much interest have you gotten from students and even faculty on campus?
Well, certainly there's been a tremendous amount of interest from both students and faculty. Obviously, I was a little disappointed that we didn't get more people coming to the road show, but 20 was still pretty good given the horrible weather. And I can easily see it getting up to 40 or 50 interested students before the fall.
That's good. That's really interesting.
Yeah.
Now, you mentioned that rowing was here at one time in the 60s and 70s, and then it was terminated. So do you have any reason why it was, do you know why it was terminated at all?
Well, I've been in touch with the former coach, the only coach that Buffalo State had, Jim Schaub, and also many of his rowers. And they tell me that the rowing was never popular with the athletic department here. And when the West Side Rowing Club had a fire in 1974, which destroyed their boathouse and, of course, many of the boats, many of the rowers viewed this as the athletic department's opportunity to terminate the program. There was never any effort to restart it after the boathouse fire.
Now, it was a successful program, so why was there any disdain for the program?
It was I don't know. I suspect maybe it took money away from football. I don't know. I'm not absolutely certain about this. I think it was a club, but maybe they did get some assistance from the athletic department as well. I'm not clear on that, I confess. There was just never any attempt to restart the program.
So would you say your goal would be the same as Jim Schaub's, is to take this program from infancy and then turn it into a powerhouse like he did in the 70s?
Oh, absolutely. I'd like to start as a club. I think that's obvious what we'll have to do, but at some point, I would like to at least see the women get varsity status. That would probably take a while, however. But I would point out, by the way, in 1974, when the program was terminated, Jim Schaub was coaching over 50 rowers, and that was just a men's program back then. So it was a very successful program.
Do you think rowing is prominent enough in Western New York to have it be such a strong program once again?
Oh, absolutely. Most local high schools row. All of the colleges row. We're the only one that doesn't, in fact, although perhaps you saw that UB just terminated their women's varsity program. They will continue to row as a club, however. And almost all Canadian high schools and universities, well, all of the universities and high schools in Canada row, actually. So there's plenty of competition in the area, and there are many regattas both here and across the border in Canada.
Yeah, so what can students expect to get out of the club if they join?
A lot of hard work and a great deal of satisfaction. It's like a lot of sports. It's a very demanding sport, physically demanding sport. I've even heard many people's rowers say that rowing is not a fun sport. But I personally find it addicting. I get a great deal of satisfaction out of it. Early mornings is the best time to be on the water. And it is a sport that most collegiate rowers actually continue after college. That can't be said of many other sports. And so there obviously is something to it, that people take it up and don't drop it.
So do you plan on having like a big role in the club, or like what role do you plan on playing, being involved in?
I'm just a promoter, really. I certainly am not a coach. I wouldn't dream of coaching, and that would be one of the first things we'd have to do, would be to hire a coach, someone who actually knows what they're doing. I'm an enthusiast.
Oh, so you'd just be a supporter of the club then?
Absolutely, yeah.
Okay, so what is the ultimate goal of the club, would you say?
Well, besides enlisting interested men and women students, one of the things that many faculty and staff have asked about is there any possibility that we might start a faculty-staff team as well? And so that's something to consider as well.
Where can students find out more information about your club?
Well, I put up flyers all over the place with my email address on them, so they can look me up. If they have one of those flyers, they can email me, certainly telephone me, and otherwise find me through the department website.
So has there been any other faculty members that have been involved in...
I should actually give credit to Susan McCartney, who's in the small business group here at Buffalo State. And we've had a lot of help from Rick Johnson as well, who's in the Research Institute. No, I've not done this alone, so they've helped a great deal as well, Susan in particular.
So if the program doesn't get greenlit or it gets shut down again, do you think students would be able to join the Westside Rowing Club instead of having the program here on campus?
Oh, absolutely. They can always do that. But I think it would be more fun to have a Buffalo State team.
For sure.
With men's and women's. And... yeah, we will certainly do that through the Westside Rowing Club, but the goal, as I said, is to be on the water this fall is the Buffalo State Men's and Women's Rowing Club.
As a rowing club?
Yeah.
And maybe by the spring, maybe turning it into a team, or maybe next year?
Well, maybe.
Maybe?
Might take a little more than that. We'll see.
Okay. Thank you for joining us today.
Well, thanks for having me.
It was very informative. Up next, we have Kai Blake Lewis with the recap for the 10th annual Runway Fashion Show.
3, 2, 1, QM, take camera 2.
You're watching the Buffalo Review TV, produced by Stripes Media. You can find out more about our show at our website, thebuffaloreview.wordpress.com, and we welcome your feedback. If you have a question, comment, or story idea, you can email us at thebuffaloreview@gmail.com.
Welcome back to the Buffalo Review TV. I'm Kai Blake Lewis, and today I'll be recapping the Runway 10 fashion show that just happened this past Saturday. I'm here to speak with Ania Taylor and Bianca Louie about their roles and experience in the show. Hi, ladies. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having
us. It's so good to see you.
Thank you.
So I just wanted to say, if you can state who you are.
Okay, my name is Bianca Louie. I'm a junior here at Buffalo State, also a psychology major.
Awesome. And Ania?
Well, my name is Ania. I'm a senior, so I'm graduating in May, and my major is public communication.
Oh, that's dope. So where are you guys originally from?
I'm from Brooklyn, New York.
Hey, Brooklyn.
Yeah, I'm from Brooklyn, too.
Me too. Okay, Brooklyn crew. I like it. So how does it feel to have been a part of the fashion show, this being the 10th time that they've done it?
For me, it was a great experience. From throwing fashion shows to actually being able to be in one, it was a real change of reversing the roles.
So from throwing fashion shows... Okay, we're jumping ahead a little bit, but I did my research, and I know that you are part of the Fashion Student Association here on campus. Am I right?
Yes, I am.
So you guys do throw fashion shows. So, right. Yes. So explain a little bit more about that.
Okay, so we are the Fashion Student Association here on campus. We throw fashion shows for the student body. The fashion show is geared towards showing off young designers who are students here on Buffalo State for the student body to view their artwork and throughout their clothes. So having to be on the other side and being able to walk in a show rather than being on the production team, it was a real good change.
That's awesome. And Ania, how about you? How was it like? What was your role in this show?
Well, I was a volunteer, so I just helped out with setting up anything that needs to be helped out around the performance or the stage or anything like that.
So in your opinion, how smoothly did the show run behind the scenes?
It was really smooth. Like this year, there was no interruptions, no intermission, so everything was right after the other, and everything was very smooth from greeting people to coming in to being backstage, helping the designers and the models. Everything was just really smooth.
Oh, that sounds really cool. That's awesome. So is this your first time both participating in the show?
Yes, it is my first time.
Okay.
Yeah, same here.
Oh, so what made you guys want to do it this year?
Okay, I wanted to participate in Runway as a model last year. I couldn't due to other reasons. So this year, when the opportunity came to me, my president and vice president of my organization right now, they're actually on the production team for Runway. So that was like a good step in, a foot in the door for me to actually, you know, be a part of the show.
Right. That's cool. And Ania?
Yeah, well, my friend had told me about it, and I had sent them an email saying that I would like to volunteer, and I just wanted to do it, you know, just to put something on my resume and also be a part of something big, because I know it was their 10th anniversary. So.
Right. And then it's your senior year, yeah. So it was like, goodbye, Buff State.
Yeah.
My last stamp on campus. I helped
definitely.
Out. That's definitely dope. So what was your favorite part about the show, or like your role in the show? Like, did you have fun? Like, what was the best moment that you can pinpoint?
I would say my favorite part was actually walking, going down the runway.
Ooh.
That would be my favorite part.
Really? So were you nervous? Like, was the runway super long?
At first, I was a little nervous before the show started, but then I got a lot of confidence through, you know, everyone saying they love the garment I was wearing and just seeing, like, what the crowd looked like and how the stage and the lighting. And then by the time it was my turn to walk, like, all my nervousness went out the window.
Right. So you were just like, hi, I'm here on the runway. I'm
yes.
about to strut myself America's
yes.
Next Top Model style. I like it. And Ania, so what was your favorite part? Like, being a helping hand backstage and all of that.
I actually had two favorite parts. My first was greeting people, because I was like the first face people saw when they came into the show.
A pretty face to greet people.
Yes. And you know, people were so excited. People were dressed so nicely. And it was just like, that was fun seeing people actually want to come out and stuff. And then I also enjoyed seeing the models behind stage getting ready to get on the stage, and then when they come off, like a relief, because it was like they're done, and it was just really exciting.
Right.
And fun.
I know that must have been really cool, because you got to see the front and the back action. It was kind of like double you know, vision there.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that's awesome. So, and then you also kind of like were part of how things worked and flowed.
Right.
That's really cool.
Mm-hmm.
So is there anything that you guys can take that you've learned during this process and that you can use in future endeavors, if you guys throw another fashion show next year, or if you happen to get a job somewhere else? Like, what can you take away from this experience?
That I am capable of modeling.
Hey, making it down and up that runway.
Definitely, if I have the opportunity of being another fashion show to walk as a model, I definitely would take it.
And Ania?
You know, working as a team, because whenever you go somewhere, every job you have, you need to have the skills working as a team, being able to take directions and follow directions, and also just being able to take initiative when things need to
right.
be done.
Right. I can agree with that, because being a team is probably one of the biggest things that made that run so smoothly. Because if you're saying, you know, that you were working backstage and you've seen how everything just kept going, that means obviously one person wasn't working together. It was cohesive, because
right.
there's no I in team.
Right.
So I know you mentioned that you were walking. We know you're the model right now, and we actually got a couple of photos. Don't ask me how I got them, but the crew and I put a little slide together so all the viewers can see how Bianca looked on the runway. This is your first look, and basically, can you explain what you're wearing in the garment?
Okay, so in this first look, below is like under the top piece is a cat suit, a full body cat suit, and then the top layer is kind of like a one overall jacket.
It looks so dope.
Yes, and then paired with leather boots. It was really, really, it was incredible.
So, Ania, would you wear this to the club?
I don't know about the club, because I might sweat, but
it does look
I would
a little
wear
hot.
It somewhere. I don't know where I would wear it, but I would wear it. I just don't know where.
Like winter.
Yeah,
well,
winter.
Okay, yeah,
winter
I could see that. And you know, we're in Buffalo, so
right.
that lines
definitely,
up well with our weather.
Definitely a chic winter outfit.
Right, I yes. really could appreciate that. And I seen that there was a whole collection there in the photo, so who was the name of your designer?
Our designer was actually a visiting collection from Beijing.
Ooh, yes. International
his name,
now.
Yes,
okay.
His name was Young. And he put together those three pieces and came all the way from Beijing.
Wow.
To present his collection for Runway.
That's amazing. Mm-hmm. So I don't even know Buff State. Okay, so we're flying in designers now. Oh, we're doing it big over here. That's so dope. So that must have been really cool for everyone to watch. I know that you said it was a collection of three, so can you just explain the two other outfits a little bit for anyone who may
yes,
not have seen?
Yes, the two other pieces were... they were kind of like they were a cohesive collection. So each piece also had like a undersuit paired with like, you know, abstract asymmetrical top of different variations. So mine was like one set of patterns, yeah. another one with a different like ruffle set of patterns. So they were all kind of like, you know, cohesive, but just different like structured.
Right. So Ania, did you get a chance to catch Bianca on the runway, showing her stuff and Young's designs?
I didn't get a chance. Well, I got it from the screen from backstage because there was a screen showing what's okay. on stage. And I did see her before she went on. So we were like all back there, but I really liked that. That was one of my favorites, like his whole collection.
Yeah, no, it looks so dope. I just want to say chic.
Yeah.
Boom.
Yeah.
That describes it all, right? Mm-hmm. So if you could say one last thing about the show and the overall experience of Runway 10, what would it be?
I would say that I think what the fashion department does with Runway is an extremely incredible thing. The whole purpose of Runway is taking all senior designers in the FTT department and showing off. It's like their senior capstone project. And I think it's a wonderful experience for them because people from all over come and see them. And a lot of people have been scouted. There was alumni designers there. One particular, he was one of my favorite. He was a graduate of Buff State. He came back as alumni designer, and he now works for Calvin Klein.
What's his name?
I really forgot his name.
Oh no, okay.
I don't want to misquote his name.
No problem.
But I think it's really wonderful what the FTT department does for upcoming designers who do graduate from Buffalo State. So I think it's a really wonderful show in general.
Yeah, it does sound like an amazing opportunity. If I were a designer, like that's
yes, it's something I would look forward to, especially knowing that you can seek opportunity. There might be someone there who loves your collection, like I would like her to come work for me.
Right.
You never know.
And Ania, last remarks about your experience and everything about the show.
Well, I think I had a great time, you know, from setting up at 10 o'clock in the morning to watching the show at 8 o'clock. And I feel like it's a really good experience for those who haven't done it or haven't even been to one. I feel like as a Buffalo State student, you should at least go to one while you're here. And if you have the chance to volunteer, because it's a great experience, you don't have to be a fashion major to enjoy a show or be a helper or volunteer. You can be any major, and it's going to help you in anywhere. So I think the overall experience was really great.
That's amazing. So, wow, I'm so happy that I got a chance to speak to you guys and get a little bit of insight. I'm definitely going to get my ticket for next year. But thank you for coming on Buffalo Review TV. I'm so happy to have spoken to you guys.
Thank you for
and
having us.
No problem.
Thank you.
All right, ladies. So, I'm Kai Blake Lewis, and that's the Buffalo Review TV.
The Buffalo Review TV, produced by Stripes Media. We welcome your feedback. If you have a question, comment, or story idea, you can email us at thebuffaloreview@gmail.com.